is a new ball teaching to begin with?
Look, I learned about the new ball, art of new ball. It was very late in my career. It was in the beginning when Imran used to give me an old ball and ask me to bowl quick. Just bowl quick and bowl with the old ball, bowl reverse swing and bowl quick. And that's what I used to. This is my early days. And, you know, that's my first tour to Australia. This was Adelaide. I remember this. And this is what I used to do, bowl quick. And that's what I've learned in my first maybe 5-6 years of my career. And also county cricket taught me a lot of this reverse swing. And later on in my career, when probably Imran left and then Akif went out of the side, somebody had to take the new ball. And I took the new ball and I started learning that. This is all reverse swing, what you're seeing. This is probably midway through the innings when the ball is reversing a little bit. But with the new ball, it's a different ball game. It's not the way you just saw. You have to be really in control of the ball. Reverse swing is you don't really have to worry about the wrist position much. But with the new ball, you have to really make sure that your fingers are right behind the ball and your thumb. Some bowlers use the thumb in this way, like Waseem Akram does it like this. I feel very uncomfortable doing it like this. But I'm more of a guy who will probably keep the first knuckle on the corner of the seam, just to get a good grip on the ball, and so when I release the ball, it comes out of my hand quite nicely. This is the control.
The ball's quite well back in your hand.
Yeah.
Well back. It's not fingertips.
Yeah, because whenever we talk about fast bowling, we talk about West Indies, and West Indies were big guys, big units, and they had big hands. They didn't need to control the ball. So my hands are like, compared to them, a little smaller. So probably I need it to be right back in my hand. But the most important thing is of course when you get into your action, yeah, you've got to be in a good position to release the ball. Some guys like to have a bit of gap in between the two fingers. But I used to keep it very very close. All what you need to do is just make sure when you get into your action, you keep your front shoulder as sideways as much as you can, and as you come down, you got to really make sure that you show this palm, this part of your hand to the bowler, and come down like this. That's where you get the outswinger going, and that's the key. The key part, the major key is your front shoulder. You got to really keep it upright as long as you possible.
So if you're trying to swing the ball in with a new ball, what will you do with that front shoulder?
Oh, you just take it out of the position a little bit earlier. But you still got to make sure that you stay on the pitch. Don't get off the pitch.
On the follow through, you mean?
Don't get off the pitch too early. Just stay on the pitch as long as you possible, because by doing that, you'll get a bit more bounce. So to just to swing it in, I used to move my thumb from putting the knuckle to just come bit more on the side, on the left side of the ball, and then just break the wrist a little bit rather going this way, just go that way, just a touch, not a lot. And I wasn't a big in-swing bowler with the new ball. All I used to do is go big outswinger, and try to sort of go, maybe give a scramble seam and keep the ball straighter. Just snip back a touch. You don't really need the big in-swingers.
Okay, I'm going to swap now and give you an old ball.
Yeah, that's easy.
What we've done, well, it's a newish ball, but what we've done is we've scarred it, okay? So we've roughed up one side of that ball. Mm. Talk to us about reverse swing, and Waz were the masters.
This is an easy part, I feel, in bowling. And nowadays, reverse swing is necessity. If you don't have someone who bowls reverse swing in the team, you are struggling as a team. So I feel...
Can we just look at you in action first, just to scare the life out of everybody? Yeah. Because this is in slow-mo, what happens? Look how long the ball stays straight, and then at the last minute, it dips in. That's impossible to bat against.
Yeah, you've got to understand that, there is a serious pace behind it. And if you don't have pace, you will not beat the bat. And every batsman you'll see in that, they look to come onto the front foot. Because what I'm trying to do here is, I'm trying to push the ball away from them, like a baseball throw. I just go like that. That way, so the first initial movement of the ball is going away from them. And what the batsman started thinking is, okay, I got to go to the front foot. And that's where I'm winning.
And get driving it out here.
Yeah, that's where I'm winning. So if he goes there and the ball's going to dip, it's more of a dip than a swing.
So give us that body action, because I'm interested. So this is to bowl a fast in-swinger with the reverse swing. So you turn the ball the other way around.
It has to be, the shiny side has to be on the right to bowl that in-swinger. And what's important is that you've got to get really close to the stumps to just push the ball away from the right-hander. And also, you got to make sure that from high arm, you got to just sort of go down a little bit. You got to go a little bit slingy, so that you can just come down in this angle.
Right. So when you opened up your left shoulder, give us the full bowling action as you did for the new ball.
So basically, it's just got to go there.
Right. There. So a little more round arm.
Yeah, a little bit round arm, and got to make sure that you just push it up fuller, like baseball. That's what they do. So that's all you need to do. Just push it up, but you need a pace. Once again, I say you have to beat the bat. To beat the bat, you need 145 clicks or more behind it.
Okay, fantastic. Look at these stats. I mean, even you must be impressed with these. There are a few men in the history of the game who have 307, well, if any, 373 and 416 in one-day cricket. Average of 23.5 and 23.8. Strike rate's unbelievable. Only Dale Steyn in the modern era of the game has a marginally better strike rate than Wacker. And in one-day cricket, striking at 30. So that's 43 per 100 bowls and 30 per... Sorry, every 43 balls he was taking a wicket in Test cricket, and every 30 balls in one-day cricket, and good career best figures.